Criteria 1, vision, mission and program educational objectives, how we want to write, how the correlation we want to maintain. Next, in the criteria 2, program, curriculum and teaching learning process, how we can enhance. These two we discussed thoroughly in part 2. Come to the part 3. In this part 3, we can discuss criteria 3, course outcomes and program outcomes. It is very important. First, how we are correlating, then how we are achieving, how we are assessing the achievement. We will discuss in this part 3. And next, the continuous improvement, how we can do continuous improvement. These two criteria, sir. Criteria 3 and criteria 7 we will discuss in this part 3 of importance of accreditation. Course outcomes and program outcomes. I will take one example subject. What is course outcome? Program outcomes already discussed. How we are mapping the course outcomes and program outcomes. How we want to give the lecture notes of the syllabus. Everything we will take one example subject. Then it is easy to understand how we are doing this CO PO mapping. First, I selected thermodynamics, basically myself mechanical. So, I selected thermodynamics. Then what are the tables are allowed? What are the data books are allowed? We are giving. Next, what is your objective? Objective means it is objective of the instructor. Means faculty, not student. With this objective, I prepared the course outcomes. Expectation at the end of the course. So, objectives of mine, first I am defining. Once, I am not reading because structure only I am explaining. Next, based on the objectives, with the objectives, I started the syllabus framing. Then I can expect course outcomes by the course, 40 hours course, 50 hours course. Like project R&D projects also, while we are writing, first column we will fill the objectives. Second column, outcomes. Same like that, the coursework also. First, objectives of the course, objectives of the instructor. With this objective, I am teaching the subject. By learning of the subject, what student can achieve that 40 or 50 hour subject? Course outcomes must be specific, measurable and achievable. Generally, we want to show hierarchy, some of the faculty, they are writing 6, 7, 8 course outcomes also. Means the course outcome, how many hours you are taking? Suppose 40 hours. 3 credit course means 30 hours, 4 credit course means 40 hours, 40 lecture hours. In 40 lecture hours, 4 credit course also, you are writing 7, 8 course outcome means that course outcomes are specific, measurable, achievable. They can learn definitions. That is a course outcome. That is not a course outcome. Apply, analyze, that is important. So, course outcome must be, you don't want to write 4 or 5 or 6, number is not important. Course outcome is realistic, with that 40 hours lecture, the course outcome must be specific, measurable and achieved. And course outcome contains 3 components are required, performance, condition, criterion. After study of thermodynamics, my course outcome, I am giving that my student can design turbine. Is it possible to design turbine after thermodynamics? At least you want to complete applied thermodynamics. With thermodynamics, you can design the turbine. So, must be specific, measurable, achievable. That 40 hours lecture course. It must be include the applicability, design, analysis, utilization of modern tools. This is important. So, at least 10 hours you are taking for attaining one course outcome is somewhat, it is a realistic course outcome. Or within 1 hour, 2 hour lecture you are attaining means that is not a course outcome. So minimum 3, maximum 4 course outcome is more than sufficient for 3 credit or 4 credit course. So it contains specific measurable achievement content, and the components required in each course outcome is the performance component, condition component, criterion component. Next, industrial applicability you want to write. Why? Because we want to create zeal on the subject, interest on the subject. If I study that subject, I will gain, I can address some industrial application. That interest we want to create by giving the industrial applicability of that subject. So about thermodynamics means in power plants, refrigeration, air conditioning, there are two major areas, and automobile industry. Three areas we can cover if you know thorough with the thermodynamics. So that interest we want to create by providing industrial applicability. Next, you give the your lesson plan. Whatever the syllabus is there, for achievement of that course outcomes, give in the lesson plan manner. First unit, how many lessons you are taking, lecture hours you are taking. 6 lecture hours. Better that recorded lecture hours also you provide to the student. Before coming to your class, they will listen that lecture hour video and you will sit in the class. So there we can interaction between the student and faculty we can enhance. That interaction is required. Eye to eye contact with the student is required. So all lecture hours, video lecture hours you prepare and give to the student. We will listen the lecture hours and come to the class with prepared manner. Then discuss unsolved problems majorly. Then more interaction, and we will know the each student capability, one-to-one contact. This is the lesson plan. So example I am giving. Next we are giving course matrix. In syllabus book you can see every course matrix we are giving. This is the course outcomes. These are the course outcome 1, 2, 3, 4. I already mentioned 3 to 4 credit course means maximum 4 is more than sufficient. Realistic, you have to write the course. At least 10 hours, lecture hours is required to attain the course outcome. Then you map with the program outcome. By attaining course outcome 1, you can attain how many program outcomes? These are the domain dependent PO1 to PO5, domain independent PO6 to PO12, and program specific outcomes defined by the department. So if they defined 4 specific outcomes, 4, 2 they are defined is 2, like that. So by attaining the course outcomes, how many program outcomes you can attain? How much percentage? This is my target. It can achieve. The student attained the course outcomes, all course outcomes, then he will attain the program outcome. This much percentage. 3 means fully attained, 2 means 60% attained, 3 means 33% attained, like that. Sorry, 1 means 33% attained, 0 means not attained. Something, the scaling we are giving. That scaling only we will mention in SAR data book. So this is the course matrix. This up to now we are given our objective. By that objective, so I am teaching subject, he can achieve the outcomes. If he achieved the course outcome, means how many he can fulfill, how many program outcomes, how much percentage he can fulfill. Then all subjects we are giving. This is subject 1, subject 2, subject 3. If subject 1 completed means this much of the percentage he can fulfill the program outcomes. If he is fulfilled or not, how much percentage he fulfilled or not, by the assessment we can do. Up to now we are giving this much we can fulfill. If the curriculum and with the objectives I am teaching the subject by the teaching learning methodology and with the curriculum. But how much percentage he attained we want to calculate, that is important. Then only we can show continuous improvement, what are the improvement techniques we are using for attainment of remaining program outcomes, we will calculate. This is my target. In this target, how much percentage I attained, that one we have to calculate. For that calculation, this is the our teaching learning methodology is attaining course outcomes, and by course outcome we are attaining the program outcomes. Okay. The assessment methodology, one is direct, one is indirect. Why we are using indirect? That is a question mark. Because the direct method by examination system, I already mentioned that. The program 1 to 5 only the domain dependent, curriculum dependent. So our question bank also majorly is asking in the PO 1 to PO 5 only. Majority of the questions covered the program outcomes only domain dependent only PO 1 to PO 5. Remaining PO 6 to PO 12, the program outcome 6 to 12. How we can assess? Assessment methodology is required by indirect method. The major role playing is indirect method. So direct method by the examination, the indirect method by the feedbacks, generally alumni feedback and exit survey. These two we can made subject wise, means course outcomes attained or not also we can get. Then program outcomes separately we can take separate survey. Two types of the indirect method is there, I will explain. And employer feedback, this is main important, ethics, to check the ethics, to check the communication skills, to check the sustainable development concerned, to check lifelong learning. These very important, the employer feedback is very important. So indirect method and indirect method, combination of direct indirect method, we are assessing whatever the target we kept. That target is how much percentage I achieved. Okay. Suppose direct methodology. What we are doing direct methodology? Semester exams. It may be mid exams. It may be end exams. Next, assignments. For lab, coming to lab assignments. Projects. Seminars. Vivas. Comprehensive Viva. One thing we introduced. Every semester what he gained, will conduct one comprehensive way. Like the different assessment method, direct method we are using. Indirect, I already mentioned alumni feedback, exit survey and employer feedback. How we are mapping? First, we are attaining COs. The course outcomes are attained or not. First, we are calculating. By using that, program matrix and course outcome attainment weightage, we are calculating POs are attained or not. Same direct method and same indirect method. Okay. So, one example, same thermodynamic subject only we will calculate, then we will get clear picture about this POCO mapping. Suppose in direct method, one example I am giving, the end semester examination, 70 marks. Some rough values are given. Mid semester, 20 marks. Mid semester contains two mid exams. So, two mid exams we are conducting. Oh, highest 75%, lowest 25% marks we are considering out of 20. So, 40 marks we are conducting. Averaging 75 into highest plus 25 into lowest. So, 20 marks. Assignment, two assignments we are conducting. Each assignment contains 5 marks, so 10 marks we are giving. So these are the direct method we are using. For labs means again labs will come. So the project means project. The marks may be changed. Majority subjects I am considered, all subjects. So generally direct method we are taking 70% of weightage. Is my concern, according to my knowledge, 50-50 want to consider. Because domain independent POs attainment we want to judge means indirect method is the best method. But based on the stakeholders' availability, 30 is the minimum we are maintaining. 30% is indirect method weightage and 70% is direct method. Next, the benchmark of attainment we want to consider. This one is changing college to college. Methodology not changing. Methodology for all colleges, same method we are using. But for keeping benchmark, suppose 50% of the maximum marks, if attained more than 50% marks means benchmark is attained. That end examination, mid exams also more than 50%, assignments also benchmark more than 50%. So 50% we kept the benchmark, more than 50% we are getting, then we are assuming the attainment. How many students got more than 50%? Then we will write the percentage of attainment. Next, weightage of attainment. Weightage of attainment, how we are calculating? The percentage of attainment we know. More than 50% I kept end examination, mid examination and assignments. Generally, some of the colleges, they are putting the right way. Assignments 70%, mid exam 60%, end examination 50%, like that. That is according to your student intake, according to your assessment, your last 3 years of the marks of the students, like that. Method we finalize and we will consider that one. This is not a permanent one. Once the students are all achieve, then you change the benchmark. You move to the 60%, you move to the 70%, you move to the 80% also. There is no separate. So for calculation of weightage, above and equal 50% means we are giving weightage of 3, attainment weightage. Between 30 to 52, below 31, this also we can change. The standard, basic starting of the accreditation, we are taking the standard. Because failure student also involving. If a student is failed, means he is not attained any program outcome, that is not meaning. Even though the failed student also attained, that's why the failure student also getting job. He has gained something. So we want to consider, but their weightage we are reducing. The weightage value we are not giving 3, the weightage value we are giving only 1. It's clear. Next, the percentage of the marks and CO, course outcome 1 related, end examination, how many percentage of marks came, mid examination, how many percentage of marks came, in assignment, how much percentage of the marks is there. It's CO2 related, CO2 3, course outcome 3, course outcome 4 related, how much percentage? The average percentage of total CO1 for end mid assignment 31%, CO2 2 32%, CO3 18%, CO4 17%. Okay, all marks we know, the percentage of the weightage we know. Then above 50%, how many students got? 90 students got above 50%. Next, 48 students in between 30 to 50, CO1 related. Next, CO1 related, 20 students below 30. Okay, we are given the weightage value is 1. So, percentage of attainment, above 50, how many? 90 divided by 158, this is 56.96 my percentage of attainment. Come to CO2, come to CO3, come to CO4. Next, for all I got percentage of attainment is 56.96. So I kept 55% is my benchmark. If percentage of attainment is more than 55%, then my all COs are attained. The attainment value, the weightage, how we are calculating 90 into 3, 48 into 2, plus 20 into 1 divided by 158, we will get the attainment value. You see. So the percentage of attainment, all are 56, above 55. Next time I can put above 60, next time I will put above 70. Means every year I am increasing my teaching, enhancing my teaching learning methodology. I can increase that attainment standard. Here I kept 50 or 55. Then we got 56. All course outcomes are attained. And the CO weightage of the CO attainment value we calculated. This is I already mentioned here. Value we calculated. Simply 19 into 3 plus 48 into 2 plus 20 into 1 divided by 158. We will get the value. With this course outcome attainment weightage, how much percentage of POs I attained? Same. Sum of column number 2 into column number 3 by column number of 3. You will get the attainment of PO1. Like that PO2. Column number 1 into column number of 4 divided by sum of column number of 4. You will get like that. You will get the program outcomes. POs attainment matrix you will get. So, out of this target, how much percentage I attained, I am calculating. I am not fully attained. Even though I kept low benchmark, I am not fully attained. This is the direct method. With this, we can't give the conclusions. About PO attainment, we can't give the conclusions of PO attainment. Then, we move to the indirect method. In indirect method, I already mentioned, based on the stakeholders, the percentage of importance we can increase. At present, we are taking 30%. 10% is alumni feedback, 10% exit survey, 10% is employee feedback. This alumni feedback means collect the feedback, suggestions from the alumni, and represent regarding program outcomes, regarding course outcomes. Course outcomes is the best method, I will show. Course outcome is the best method. Program outcomes, what happened? For all year average we want to consider. Each course direct, indirect we can't club. Because program outcome, that year student outcome, program outcomes related survey we are doing means entire year, that first year, second year, third year, fourth year, the direct method calculation, then average the direct method calculation, then you add with the indirect method and you will give the average value of the PO attainment. But course outcome method is easy. Each subject, the course outcomes 4, it is attained or not. How much weightage we got? That calculation is good in an indirect method. For alumni feedback like that only, exit survey like that only, employer feedback also like that only. Then you see, this is the course outcome 1. We are giving good, fully attained 3. 60% attend 2 and minimum attend 3. We are not attend, we are not mentioned. So out of 180 outgoing students, exit students, we did survey. Then the percentage, weightage value, we required this weightage value. Based on the weightage value only, using course outcome weightage value, we are calculating the program attainment. So how we are calculating this one? 36 into 3 plus 124 into 2 plus 20 into 1 divided by 180. You will get the weightage value of CO. So 4 COs weightage value we are calculating. That weightage value, attainment value with the program outcome, same method, direct method, how we are calculating like that. The PO attainment matrix for indirect method also we are calculating. So direct and indirect. Once you know the direct and indirect, direct method and indirect method, 70% you consider direct method into 70% and indirect 30%. 70 into direct plus 30 into indirect, you can consider, then final value you will get the average program outcome attainment of thermodynamic subject. So benchmark I kept above 2 means my attainment is okay. So thermodynamic subject we got all above 2. Okay. Then next year what we will do? You increase this benchmark. Increase the benchmark of above equal and above 50%. Instead of above 50%, you move to 60%. You enhance the teaching learning methodologies. Okay, and second method of indirect attainment, directly the program outcomes directly you made the survey of alumni, outgoing students and employer, and that outgoing students first year direct method, the program outcomes attainment, second year, third year, fourth year, average the total value, and that is the direct outcome of the outgoing students program outcome attainment in direct method. Then indirect method, by survey, alumni survey, by weightage, by exit survey, by employer, 10 10 10 30%. Then average the value. Then the outgoing students attained or not, total POs, by graphically we can represent. Year wise outcomes we can represent. So this is the effective method. So method is not changing. Where the chair, by the condition of attainments, the weightage grades according to student intake, student quality of intake, we are changing the values. So initially we start with 50. After 10 years also we are maintaining 50, means we are not enhanced anything. Next 2 years, 3 years, our target enhance the weightage value to the 50 instead of 50, 60. The benchmark value is moved to 60. End examination, mid examination 80, assignment not 50, assignment 90%. Okay. So I think it is clear, CO PO mapping. This all representation will get the first, our target representation only will get 25 to 30 marks. The assessment, after assessment, the PO CO attainment matrix representation and graphical representation of CO PO mappings of last 3 year students, last 4 year students, and if you have got incremental attainment or decreasing attainment, we have to represent and the reasons of why the program outcomes not attained. If indirect method you are not adding, means our process is not completed. Because the program independent outcomes we can assess by indirect method. Major role playing method is indirect method. Next, move to the fully attainment is required. Continuous improvement. The continuous improvement based on the attainments. We want to improve the curriculum. We want to improve the teaching learning progress. We want to improve the teaching resource requirement. And you want to validate the reliability of the evaluation and assessment methods. If it is not acceptable, you change the question bank. And reliability, validity and reliability of the evaluation is main important. Next 2 years, 3 years, we are doing consistency, we are getting, means the validity and reliability of evaluation we can achieve. Okay, so these criteria, major criteria, remaining criteria already, just collect the information and upload the information. That's all. We are not calculating or we are not analyzing the things. These, in out of 10 criteria, the analyzing criteria we are discussing in part 1, part 2, part 3. And I am expressing my sincere thanks to Dr. S.K. Dasar, because after attending his course, accreditation and outcome based education, I think. Very good course, NPTEL is offering. So after attending course only, I got clear idea. So I'm expressing my sincere gratitude to Dr. S.K. Dasar. And with this, I am ending the importance of accreditation discussion. Thank you. Thank you very much.